no bigger prize than to become the number one contender and face Aung San for the world middleweight title. Leandro Ataides and Adonida, both men looking for the early flurries.
Ataides is touching him with that right hand. Every single time the Ritter steps into that range, you can see Ataides making him pay with that right hand. He's got a cock lock and ready to rock.
You know Aung San at home with his newborn daughter in Florida is watching this one right now to see his future opponent.
Good takedown defense right there from Ataides as he was able to stop that single. And he throws another right hand.
And the Ritter experiencing the power in the gloves of the hulking Brazilian. Arm heel strike there off the break from the Ritter. Good right hand again from Ataides. And to Ritter tire out Ataides. Can he throw him into deep water? And watch for Ataides, who likes to get airborne with the flying knee. Good one reaching the jab at a southwest stance there from Derrida.
But even if it does go into the second and third round, Ataides carries that power with him. He was able to knock out Big Dash in the third round, so you know he has that energy and that stamina to push at an incredible pace.
All tied up against the ropes here. Ataides has begun explosively, tagging Derrida already with the right hand. Takedown. Derrida, top position.
This is what the Ritter wanted. RDA wanted to get this on top. Now he's there. Let's see if he can separate the grip. Good job, Ataides, to work his way back up. Now he's got the back and a body lock.
Nice little walking punch off the right hand there from Leandro Ataides. And the one fantasy game, the world's largest martial arts fantasy game with the one super up. 54% of fans voting for Leandro Ataides for the win. 46% for the Dutchman Derrida.
RDR's trying to separate those hands, but a vice-like grip coming from Ataides. Looks like he might be trying to a Kimura attempt. He could use this Kimura lock right here to separate. Possum might even look for a throw.
Derrida does not know defeat. He is 11-0 with a 100% finishing rate. 3 knockouts and 8 submissions for the Dutch Knight.
You can see the Kimura grip that the Ritter's got. He's trying to use it to actually reverse the position and throw Ataides, but he kind of face plants himself right there. Ataides keeps that grip nice and tight.
The Ritter still looking for that right arm of Ataides. Ataides takes the back of the Dutchman now. 2:10 remains on the clock, an intriguing opening round. Reverse elbow there from Derrida. Will you get to meet Aung San and a guaranteed world title shot for the middleweight crown that Aung currently holds?
Good defense so far by Ataides. His base is so heavy. It's crafted with decades of grappling experience, ladies and gentlemen. He knows exactly what he's doing here. Good job by swimming underneath to get those underhooks. Gets back to a neutral position. This clinch battle is very technical, like high-stakes chess. Every move, everything this detailed encountered.
6 knockouts for Ataides, 3 for Derrida. Could we see a contender for the knockout of the night in this one? Some great contenders so far. Ataides pressing Derrida back against the ropes. What do you think of the performance of Derrida so far, Greg?
I'm more impressed right now with the performance of Ataides. He's able to stop all the potential takedown attempts, pop back up to his feet. He was in a dangerous position, but he got right back up. And now he's able to nullify a lot of the clinch. This is where we've seen the Ritter really dominate a lot of opponents inside this clinch and just manhandle people to the ground. And Ataides is doing a good job of shutting down that game.
Ataides checks the high kick, counting with the right hand, leaping punches there from Derrida. Jammed Ataides, but his guard's wide open. Derrida tried for a double leg takedown, gut-munching knee from the Dutchman. Short right hand, didn't have the power behind it. Landing clean on the beard of Ataides, but didn't wobble the big Brazilian.
The Ritter is a Dutch-trained kickboxer. You know, he trains out there with Peter Faust, who's coming off an incredible victory in the Manila, Philippines against Edward Foliang. So I know Peter Faust is screaming right now at his TV, trying to get the Ritter to throw some hands. You can just see how low Ataides carries those hands. And he's putting himself into a dangerous range, too.
That's it, good. Ataides does get the win here. There's no way he can carry the hand that low against Aung San. First Aung San catches him from the Burmese python pool, that steel pipe.
End of the first round, we go to the towels. Your thoughts after one, Mitch. Let's play coach for a moment. First of all, what do you tell the Dutch Knight to do?
I'd like to see RDR kind of chain these takedown attempts together, not just get stuck inside that clinch hunting for things. I'd like to see him change levels, start to put some wrestling on to Ataides. And Ataides, he needs to strike inside that clinch. He needs to put hands on the Ritter, make him start thinking about what he's trying to do and really start to open up. But first thing he's got to do is keep that guard nice and high. I know he likes the hands down, just sort of showboating style, and he's picking opponents apart with it, but he needs to be careful because, you know, RDR carries power in those hands, too.
We are ready to roll second round of three for the right to meet Aung San for the world middleweight title. Folks, don't forget to follow us across all your social media platforms, Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram at One Championship.
Call him in. Let's go.
Who do you think goes through? Who do you think becomes the number one contender for the strap? He's a man who will be able to beat Aung San. Aung San has been a force of nature, a two-division champion. Last time out, TKOing Brandon Vera. Southpaw stance on the air. Dutchman backs up now.
Yeah, it looks like Ataides does not respect the power of RDR at all. He's just walking through these shots, eating them moving forward. Good head movement so far, but also good countering too. He's starting to slip these punches and land uppercuts. That one touched him on the beard though.
Long reach on the jab isn't allowing for the left hand follow through cross from Derrida. Needs to get the distance in a little better here, the Dutchman. On the outside, Ataides, the guard's too low and wide. Sticks the chin out, offers it to Derrida. Trying to bait him, the Dutchman, trying to sucker him inside. Goes for a scooping bolo punch, and there's a right hand down the tube. There's the left hand. Derrida's chin momentarily high.
That's what Ataides needs to do. He needs to pressure the Ritter back. And when he does that, you can see how high the chin comes up. If he's able to connect some of these shots together in combinations, he might be able to back up and put down RDR.
Full of time here from referee Olivier Coast. Aung San, you've got to wonder what the champion is thinking right now, watching at home in Florida, about who his next opponent may be. If it's Derrida or Ataides. Great scene inside the sold out. Mr. Sanayan in Jakarta, in Jakarta's sporting precinct. Although it was pouring rain a few hours ago, just before the doors opened, it still managed to cram them inside. There's not an empty seat in the house yet. The hottest ticket in Jakarta tonight is One Championship. Wherever you're watching, in over 140 countries, folks, we hope you're enjoying it just as much as we are. Olivia to get us back underway. Pitch your thoughts at the moment. He's doing just clear by Ataides.
Yeah, so far he's doing a good job of sticking to his game plan, stopping the takedown, because at this point I think RDR kind of needs the takedown. You know, otherwise he's going to be in for a long night, because these strikes, you can just see how relaxed and how comfortable Ataides is when he is out there striking. Oh, look at that body lock takedown. So strong coming from RDR.
This is what Derrida wanted, and this is not, with Leandro Ataides standing on his back.
See, but he's just able to pop right back up. Derrida has never faced this kind of adversity and not being able to keep opponents down. Once he gets on top of you, he just smothers people. Just never lets them get back up, never lets them move, doesn't let them do anything. This is a different place for RDR to be in. Now we're gonna see if he really has that championship medal inside of him.
Derrida's got that cut over the left cross. Double jab from the Dutchman. Jab again, no left cross for company, however. Big open guard here, no respect for the power. Or maybe he thinks back of it.
Those hands did open up a cut on the mouth of Ataides. So that's what the doctor was checking out, is he's busted up on the lip. So he's, you know, Ryan Derrida still got that power, man.
shoulder drop to the inside there from Derrida. Ataides presses him in the corner. Derrida out of there. Back to center ring. 2 cents remains, second round of three. Number one contendership in the middleweight division up for grabs tonight. Derrida backs away. Ataides hands around his waist so low. Why not throw a high kick? Why not try to loop the shin around the back of the neck?
You've got to be asking yourself, what is Aung La thinking? Is he thinking that, you know, Reinier de Ritter is presenting some openings in his stand-up? Is he saying, oh, it's a bad idea for Ataides to drop his hands like that because I'm going to lay my right hand right through his head? You got to be wondering, what is the middleweight king thinking at this point in time? But right now, we're seeing Ataides with good head movement, able to slip a lot of shots and answer back.
1 minute 20 remains, second round of three. Ritter in the southpaw stance, right over the left eye. There's a cut in the mouth of Ataides. Both would have taken damage. Mitch, what does the Ritter need to do with 1-5 remaining?
Ritter needs to get this match to the ground. I like to see him change levels and attack those legs. You can see him trying to reap the outside leg, but Ataides got beautiful balance. He's just floating around, moving so well. Such heavy hips. He knows exactly what to do once Ritter starts lacing those legs up. I kind of want to see these guys hit the ground. I want to see him grapple.
Double jab there from Derrida, but again, needs to throw that left hand. He's getting a little too side on when he throws the jab. It's not allowing him to come over the top. There it is now. Once he squares up a little more to Ataides, it enables that left cross from Derrida, and he eats a right hand from the Brazilian. So much power as he loads up Ataides. Now looks for a takedown.
Ataides changing things up and going for a double leg of his own, but good defense from RDR to stop that, pull him back up to his clinch position.
Derrida comes forward. A little bit of sloppy punching there from the Dutch Knight. I'd love to see a roundhouse kick to the neck of Ataides, but the hand's so low, he may just catch it. And we're going to go into the deep water. We are going to go into the third and final round.
I know you said those punches are sloppy, Michael, but he is touching him with it. And when you get an unorthodox striker throwing punches from weird angles, you sometimes land. There's Ataides trying to go airborne and connect with a flying knee. Good backward movement by RDR there to avoid really any major shots. You can see Ataides touching him there a little bit, but no big damage shown in that exchange right there. But in this case, we need to see a little bit more aggression when Ataides is moving backwards, trying to avoid those punches with his hands down. If Reinier de Ritter starts putting combinations together, going to the body, and then possibly throwing that head kick, there might be something for him there. Ataides needs to shift gears and apply a little bit more pressure and speed to these shots.
Mitch, who's the bigger threat, as you see it right now, to Aung San Suu?
At this point in time, from what I've seen from this match, I would think Leandro Ataides is a little bit more well-rounded, similar to Aung La. Aung La is a banger, a tried and true blue collar, punch you in the face, move forward, and stop you. But he's also got a good ground game, and Ataides could battle him in both those areas. Reinier de Ritter might get picked apart in the stand-up from Aung La.
Third and final round, 5 minutes remaining for somebody to claim that world title tip. We're looking to lock in a more tight clinch momentarily. There's a roundhouse kick for the hook game from the Dutchman. And he got a bit more gusto behind him now, Reinier de Ritter. Right hand lead from Ataides, dances off to Brazilian.
One big shot, you know, a little bit of internal damage. You can wobble your opponent, you might be able to take this. It's really anybody's match as we're approaching that, you know, the 11 minute mark of this number one contender battle.
Ritter looks for a crossing elbow just to the hairline of Ataides, now ties him up. They tango over in the corner. Ataides turned him around, beautiful. Looping left hand and a straight front from Ataides. The power elbow. And the Ritter closes it down.
The Ritter needs to be careful when he's moving backwards. That head goes way up in the air. But Ataides just can't quite find the range when he's running backwards.
It's the common mistake of a tall man's defense. It's natural to lean back and raise the chin. Try to use your height. When you're against a guy like Ataides, it could be disastrous.
But I think Ataides is a little bit tired at this point. You can see he's a little bit wear down, not quite moving as explosively. He's still got confidence. He's still marching forward. Oh, what's happening? Looks like a possible groin shot.
Referee Olivia goes golden time.
Yeah, let's take a look at it. It looked like in the exchange here, it was a knee. Yeah, right there. Boom. You can see that right inside the cup there. And then Ataides tried to protect, and that's when he got hit with a couple of shots. An athlete is allowed up to 5 minutes for doctor's examination and recovery. If an athlete is unable to continue, since we are past the halfway point, we will go to the judges' scorecards.
Let's take one more look nice and slow and see exactly where this knee was placed. Off the right leg. Mitch, it looked high to me. It didn't hit the groin.
Yeah, I
think it doesn't hit the groin. From what I see, it didn't hit the groin.
It's a bad angle, but I think it hits the groin and then goes up to the stomach.
It looks like it hit the stomach to me. Your thoughts, folks, on social media, at One Championship on Twitter, Facebook, YouTube, and Instagram. Rita complaining that he doesn't believe it was a groin strike. A little controversy here in the third round. It is still anyone's match for the taking. And what is on offer could not be bigger. A title tilt, an online sum for world championship gold in the middleweight division. I believe it is okay to go on. He's still low on the Brazilian dragon.
Yeah, he's got good head movement, so he's kind of relying on his head being able to react to these shots coming from Ritter. And that's why Ritter, if he puts at least two or three punches together, he's going to catch him on the third one, especially because you can see that, you know, either he leans back or he's slipping to the outside. He follows that up with a big cross. Nice little body shot there landed by Ataides.
Is Reinier de Ritter starting to slow down now, sucking a bit of air. The gas tank may be depleting on the Dutchman. Under 3 minutes remains. Ataides just shrugs him off. The hulking Brazilian fakes the right, fakes the left, leads with the right, scoops the left, everything misses. Almost walks him to a knee. Double leg, takes him to the corner. Ritter holding the ropes there.
Yeah, I think his arms flailed back and he might have tried to balance himself on the ropes a little bit. The referee chose to restart it. Good call by Olivier Coste. You know, this is usually what happens, ladies and gentlemen, when you get two high-level grapplers, it kind of nullifies each other and you get a stand-up battle.
This is what Ataides wanted, not so Ritter. Ataides' high kick couldn't get the proper torque or pivot on the lead foot. Both men's gas tanks seem to be depleted. He can never rule them out, especially Ataides. He could throw one big thumping right hand. There's a nice lift from Derrida. Overhooks the right arm. Gives up on that. Puts it on again. And there'd be a knee here from Ataides. That's a knee from Derrida. 1:45 remains. Who will put the foot down? A tango against the ropes. Nice knee there from Derrida. What's he got left in the tank here? The Dutchman crossing elbows. Ataides backs him off. Nice head movement then from the Brazilian. Finally from Derrida. Tries to loop it up to the beard. Another gap-munching knee. Belly button through the back.
You can see DeRitter's got a lot of knees inside that clinch. He's trying to use them effectively by breaking down the body. He might want to try to wrap his hands around the clinch, around the head, and start throwing knees to the head because he's got about 60 seconds. He might be slightly behind the scorecard, but it's not a clear-cut, you know, runaway victory for Ataides. This is pretty close either way you're going to cut it. Ritter could really try to pour it on right now.
What is going through the mind of Aung San Suu as he watches in Florida? Shoulder thrust there from Derrida in the corner. 38 seconds remain. Body shot then to the jaw. Needs a little bit more stuff behind it, does Derrida. Backs Ataides up. Against the rope, overhooking the arm. Ataides gets free. 25 seconds down. Double leg attempt there from Derrida. No avail though. Ataides glances to his corner. The winner is a mess. Has he got one big salvo left? Maybe a Hail Mary punch. He's looking for a takedown. That won't work for him, though. He's going to go down to the judges here.
But that was a good battle. That was a very closely contested middleweight contest for the number one contender spot. You got to see a lot of striking from both individuals. Ataides had a little bit more volume putting together the shots, you know, but you never know when it goes to the judges' scorecards. You can see inside that clinch, Ryan Ritter was really active. He was constantly pushing forward. But this is where Ataides could start to take advantage. Having Reinier de Ritter on his back foot, trying to keep his composure, trying to keep things together. But Ataides just constantly pushing forward, throwing those big lunch boxes of hands of his.
Who will face Aung Lan Sung for the world middleweight title? Will it be the Netherlands versus Myanmar? Or will it be Brazil versus Myanmar? We're about to find out. Tom Lau is in the ring. We have the decision in hand. Both men believe they've got it. Let's go to Tom Lau to find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, to present the medal for this match, we have President Director of Credivo, Mr. Ali Tan. And now, ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have called this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Reinier de
It is going to be Myanmar versus the Netherlands.
Aung Lan, are you ready? You pick the place, you pick the time, you pick the date. You deserve it. But keep that f***ing belt shining, because I'm coming for it. Let's go!